And welcome, everyone, to the UPSL National Quarterfinals here in Championship Stadium, Irvine, California. You are a few moments away from watching what I think will be a very interesting match. Valley 559 FC versus CD Delphine de Abasolo. My name is Simon Allen. I'm the Dalai Lama of soccer. Today I am sitting next to one of my good friends, an absolute LA soccer legend, Danny Califf. Danny, how are you?
Oh, pleasure to be out here today, Simon. It's nice. Great day, great day for soccer. So I'm excited to look, and I'm looking forward to it.
We'll see what happens, because when we were driving to Irvine, it was nice and sunny, and we were wearing T-shirts and shorts, and as soon as we got into the OC, it became sort of rainy and muggy, and I'm sure that this wasn't what was expected by the two teams that are going to be playing on the pitch right now. Interesting turn of events. We went around and we saw them do the pre sort of match warm-ups. Anything catch your eye, Danny?
Well, I think it's funny, as we were talking about earlier, that teams around the world seem to do the same things for warm-ups, and so that's interesting. And but you know, these teams look like they have players, and it's going to be good, exciting football to watch. I'm excited. We have a good crowd here, and I think that they're going to be in for some entertainment.
We're going to wait for the national anthem right now. See that the fan base has traveled really well for this particular match. Waiting for the national anthem, but I don't think it would be too disrespectful if we talk while we wait, Danny. Do you think?
No, I think we're filling some space here.
Okay. Well, I'm sure we'll be told when the music gets played. Again, I think it's very important that we stand for the national anthem when we can. You know,
absolutely.
Obviously. And I'm sort of watching while everyone else is watching. We were talking about the players, Danny, and how they're up for it. We spoke with a few of the two of the head coaches, and they're absolutely up for it. They think they can absolutely win and get to the semifinals, which again, the finals are going to be on the other side of the United States of America, which should be a fantastic opportunity for UPSL to spread its footprint.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sort of reminds me of a story of one of the first times I was color commentating, and the stereo system for the national anthem had something happened, didn't quite work, and so I went and rushed to the stadium mic, and I went, "I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, you know, the just please remain standing, and we're trying to figure something out. And the whole stadium started sort of yelling, you sing the national anthem.
Okay.
And I, for the life of me, I, you know, I'm not a very good singer. And I said, well, why don't you guys sing? Because we were really close. You know, the booth was very close to the fans. Why don't you sing? And the entire stadium sung the national anthem.
Oh,
like, you know,
fantastic.
And it was just, I was like, wow. It's sort of, the like this sort of air sort of hit me in the face, and all the singing and the notes and everything. I thought that was one of the coolest moments of my sort of career. Here we go. Just off camera, you can hear the drum beats of Escuadrón, the traveling fans, the valley, and now obviously the high fives and the fist bumps, Danny. It's customary all around the world. Both teams going back to get some final instructions right about now. Yeah, nerves should be completely out of the system, right?
I'm sorry?
Nerves should be completely out of the system right now.
Yeah, I mean, I think until the ball actually gets rolling, there's still a little bit of you know, nervous anticipation. But I think, you know, as this thing kind of, as you get out to your position, your roles kind of get clarified. It's get ready to go.
We'll see what happens here. All the referees, the referees are ready to go. Final checks. Oh, interesting stadium music. A little bit. More to my liking, but we'll see what happens. So the Dolphins are in green and white. Dolphins in green and white.
Okay.
And the valley should be in their all blacks. Been calling a lot of games, Danny, where it's been, you know, all blacks and all whites and lily whites and all that. So it feels like a rugby match most of the time. You know, so nice to see something a little bit more, a little bit, you know, a bit of a
character.
Character, yes. A little bit of spring colors. You know, on the field, so to speak. Nothing like a bit of AC/DC to start off a match.
Get everybody fired up.
Yeah, got a few stories about them too, but maybe for another broadcast. About that. I want to thank everyone for tuning in. I want to thank the TV Emax family for broadcasting. Obviously, we're watching UPSL soccer here in Irvine, California. You're probably watching this on YouTube, and I want to thank you for tuning in and simply say that without you, we're simply talking to thin air. we'll talk some more. I think that this venue is absolutely wonderful. The only thing really missing. Love to meet you at the stadium. I know you won't be disappointed. Stadium is wonderful. The football is great. Just waiting for the referee to make that call. Give you a visual of what's going on. There's people behind us banging their heads to AC/DC, and I'm loving it, getting really into the spirit of things, and some of the youngsters not knowing exactly who these rock and rollers are, but the real rock and rollers are on the pitch. Absolutely. They're gonna be rocking and rolling in a minute, so we'll see how it goes. And here we go, game on, folks. Stadium announcer coming on with action immediately. Just a quick pass, didn't quite get to his player, and both these teams just feeling each other out right now. Taken away, and looks like the referee's calling it back for some sort of a foul infraction and a yellow card. That isn't very good for 27 seconds into the match. So far, so good, though. I mean, both teams making their presence felt. A little bit of shirt tugging over there. Don't worry, lads. You'll be able to exchange your jerseys at the end of the match. Just have a nice clean one. The fans out there are watching you. And it looks like the passion is dialed up to 11.
Straight away out the gate.
So that's very good. Of course, when there's so much passion down here, the referee stops it. And we're going to start all over again. Here we go. Back to action, folks. Valley have the ball. Taken away. Dolphins have it. Moving around really nicely. Ball is being exchanged from black shirt to green shirt. Booted away. Who can control this? We'll give it a few seconds for it to calm down a little bit. Here come Valley with the ball. Nice little one touch to his teammate. Out to touch right now. Nice big kick into the middle of the park right now. Headed down. Let's see who can actually sort of maintain a bit of possession in the first 2-3 minutes of this match. Goalkeeper quite happy and content to hold on to the ball. Gets it to his right. Leon with the ball, passes it through. Doesn't quite hit his mark, and it's going to roll gingerly away. Not out to touch yet. Very well done. Montero gets it back into the middle of the park. Stolen. Almost like a pickpocket. Here come the Dolphins. Right now, look, nice little through ball here. Certainly something's going to happen. And very well done.
Good cover coming across.
That was Torralva with just, yeah, amazing little sort of had good vision. Very smart play. For their efforts, though, the Dolphins do have a corner kick. It might be a short one. No. I'm betting dollars to donuts it isn't now. So we'll see. Dolphins in green and white. It is short. I would have lost my own bet. Here comes the Dolphins. Certainly a shot. And again, just kicked out to safety. That was Cazares doing the defensive work. Can you hear me? I'll shout. Get a second bite of a cherry over here with a corner kick. Dolphins now looking to do something. There's a little bit of talking. This is actually let me be frank here. There's a bit too much talking between the refs and the players. Let's get on with the business of football, folks. Nice corner, goes in and hits the side netting. Referee saw an infraction there, a little bit of a push, and going to call a foul.
Trying to cool temperatures down a little bit.
Yeah, it's almost like, we know you're two tough teams. We figured it out in the first 4 minutes. But we also know that you play some really beautiful football, so let's see that.
Absolutely. Let's put our energy and focus there.
Back to action, folks. Again, just to remind you, Simon Allen, the Dalai Lama of soccer. That's me. Next to me, Danny Califf. Happy to be in Irvine, California, doing this quarterfinal match, the UPSL National Quarterfinals. Want to go ahead and also thank Del Real, Hispanic Flavors for Modern Life. Fantastic food. It was a product that I was already using, and they came on board UPSL, and so glad that they are here, and they are here at this match as well. Throw in for Valley. Dolphins have to go ahead and chase. Back to defense. Very happy to send it back to the goalkeeper. Cabarro sees his player to his left, gets it. Now bags of space. Can Valley do something with that? Campos knows he can get the ball to his teammates and quite gingerly gets it back to the center backs. A lot of traffic in the midfield, but they're going to go ahead and bypass that right now. Oh, can he stay on his feet? He does. And just taken away. Look at Dolphins just getting that ball by hook or by crook at this point, right?
Yeah, it was a good aggressive play initially, but he stayed on his feet and kept his balance and was able to keep going. And Dolphins got another crack at the cherry.
Here we go. You can see the replay right now. And just good on that. He just wanted to get up and continue that attack. Most forwards would try to get a call right there and then. And here we go. Free kick. Could be dangerous, but maybe going short right now. A lot of bodies in the box. Here we go. Nicely floated in. Something's going to happen. No. Here we go. Surely a shot. Just couldn't keep his balance and kicked into traffic. And for their efforts, they do get a corner kick, Danny.
Yeah, it was just hopped up on him there. He couldn't really get it down to the floor quick enough to get a shot. But it's good pressure here.
Something I noticed, Danny, is that these players aren't like 6'8" and 7 foot. They're a little bit shorter than, and again, with all due respect, they're fantastic players, but they're not tall.
No.
Like, I've been seeing a lot of tall players in this league, and this game, not so much. So they might be a lot of those sort of P-rollers, I like to call them, into the area. Oh, look at that. And as soon as I say that, the guy has a 2 foot vert going into like a volleyball player trying to get that header. Shows me up, doesn't he?
It was a good effort. It was tough to get power on it moving away from goal, but it was a good effort. And a chance for Valley to bring the big boys up and put a ball in the box.
Little secret, I am, I do have a tall voice, but I'm actually 4'2" myself. So everyone is taller than me. Obviously kidding. But everyone is taller than me.
No.
There we go. A lot of talking, but teammates talking, and team talking to the assistant referee. We've got to get back to action, folks. And here's Valley with the ball. Can they control it? It's just absolutely smothered right now. There's three players on him. They just absolutely pickpocket the player. And there's a little bit of a shoulder charge over there, too. You spot that one, Danny?
Well, doing whatever they can to keep the thing in.
And he's actually still talking to the player that he shoulder charged into. I love this. Let's talk about the football. Let's do it. Come on. Here we go. Good movement right now. Back and forth. Just not. Oh, look at that. Look at that. He had his elbow up, folks. And the referee's going to stop this all the time. So at one point, the manager's probably going to have to say, listen, guys, we know you're tough. We know. Look at this. Boom.
Going to have to settle down and start playing some football here pretty quickly.
And I think both these teams have to sort of get serious about it. They're not going to win by muscle.
Yeah,
they're
going
to win by skill. And these two teams, they got skill. We've seen it before. Look. you know, they say you win games by hook or by crook, but, you know, the most often times you win games by skill and passion and, you know, and, you know, so back to action, folks. We've seen both these teams play very, very well getting here. Dolphins have the ball, getting back. Bags of space to his left and right. Chooses to go back. Trying to find space.
Both teams doing a good job of keeping possession along their back line, looking for times to go forward.
And here's a nice run into the box. He's going to have to sort of, does he get him? No. It does a good job. I mean, it's physical. I mean, it's what you're taught in the academy. You know, to let that ball run and absolutely go ahead and shield the player. So it worked.
Yep. It was good. He read the ball early and was able to get his body in between and run the play out.
Kabara now. Before I had mentioned the other goalkeeper's name, I apologize. That was actually Hernandez from the Dolphins. So he... don't want him to come back after the game and tell me I got him wrong. So both goalkeepers very well respected across the league. Here come Valley right now. Montero just lobs it in there. Maintaining possession back to...
Dolphins seem pretty comfortable with these aerial balls being sent in. Valley's got to look to play more to feet in order to, and through the lines to get in behind.
There are whole teams, Danny, that sort of want to bypass that midfield because it's just so much traffic in there. And there are teams who've just got the skill to do whatever they want to do, even in traffic. Both these teams, I think, what do you think? I mean, I have seen them do both things, do them both very, very well. There you go. Good movement. Back and forth. Someone's going to have to maintain possession. Physical. Out to touch right now. And no one really...
They're battling everywhere.
Everywhere. They're going to battle for the water bottles in halftime. I can guarantee it. Gladiators that they are. Back to the defenders.
Dolphins stepping a little higher with their line.
There's a, looking for a pocket of space in the back, but just booted back into the mix. Someone's going to have to keep control of this. Then no one's doing it right now. It's a throw-in. Dolphins with the throw-in. It's not going to be quick. Oh, that's just cheeky. Oh, into the space. Certainly a shot. No, very selfish. Takes the shots. Yes, there it is. No, the goalkeeper dies for it.
What a goal line clearance.
Defensively fantastic, Danny.
Yeah, absolutely. Good commitment to stand tall, make the block.
Oh, slide tackle, studs up. Referee goes, no, play on. Certainly. Something going on here, ref. And just physical. There's a player down, and the referee didn't see anything wrong with that slide tackle. I beg to differ, but we don't have the luxury right now of a of a replay. The referee certainly doesn't have that luxury. But there's a player down and he's not happy and he's not getting up anytime in the next couple of seconds.
Definitely came in with his stud showing. And
didn't he? Is that a yellow for that tackle from? So now it's the referee has to maintain a bit of control, doesn't he? Look, there's that. There's the right here. Look at this.
Good positioning, good taking up space, and great commitment to leave his head in there and make the block.
So, I mean, Leon definitely got a foul on that side of the pitch. Shoulder to shoulder, where it was just we went in like almost like a rugby, like an American football tackle. Mm. But on this side of the pitch, it was definitely something that has to be said about that sliding tackle. We love sliding tackles, obviously, but
Not when they're endangering the
opponent. Absolutely. They want to keep this 11-on-11, that's for sure. Do we see it there? Yeah. Oh, my word. Thank you, TV
yeah,
Max
definitely
family
deserving
for bringing that.
Of a yellow.
Yeah.
For
that's
sure.
That's a yellow, yeah. I mean, technically, studs up could go straight to red. And
yeah.
I don't want that. I'm not saying that. Because I love games that are 11-on-11. I don't like it when it's thrown for a loop. I want to see both these teams with a
evenly
plan.
Evenly matched
yeah.
and getting after each other. Absolutely.
So right now, back to sort of action. Nicely floated in, and certainly no. What a scramble in the box. That could have just been tapped in.
Fantastic delivery. Fantastic bent ball whipped in with some pace. Really creates lots of problems for the defenders and the goalkeeper, but coming up huge with the save, being big and brave, getting down his body in between it.
Got to give a kudos to the goalkeeper as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. Great save.
Well done, Hernandez. Going straight to the ground. Didn't worry about whose feet his header would have to smash into. Certainly. Good job there. Back to action, folks. Leon with the ball. Got bags of space. No one's going to go near him right now. He survived that bone-crunching tackle and just rolls out to touch. Referee's looking for... Yeah. Don't know if the audience in the YouTube can listen, but full voice on the traveling fans. Gotta love that.
Gotta love it. With the drum, too, keeping time, it's great. Lots of traveling support here for these young men.
Corner kick. Valley does a good job getting it into the box. Doesn't get quite past the first defender. It's in the middle of the park right now. They still maintain control. Campos has it. Gets it into the box, but none of his teammates are there. Defensively doing well. Gets past one mark. Just over kicks it to himself. And look at that.
Valley doing a really good job of holding the ball in. Continuing their counter press. See if they can get a shot off here.
Well, referee's calling them. At least that's good. I like that. Dolphins now have to sort of regroup. They wanted to do a very quick start, but Hernandez is going to take it. Nice big boot. Hit gets to the final third, just gets to Leon's head, that's all. Now Valley have the ball, bags of space. There's going to be a bit of a shirt tug here, a little bit of a scramble. Look at that. Yeah, good. Both teams dishing it out and giving it. Here we go. It's not offside. Oh, it is offside. Well spotted by the assistant referee.
Just a bit too eager there. Maybe could have got it off his foot just half a second earlier. But
so when you're defending against a fast runner like that and you're sort of back and forth with your hands, at what point do you go, sorry, and just go completely with your shoulder and just put him to the ground, Danny?
Yeah, just about that area.
That area right
yeah,
there.
Just about that area because you don't want to be too deep.
That was the perfect spot.
Yeah.
Slightly out of danger.
Right. You're going to take a little bit of a longer ball to get into the box if there's a foul.
I would want to do it like really further away, actually. There's a shot! Oh, my word!
What a finish.
Ah.
Out of nowhere.
We're looking at this side of the pitch. We turn our heads and... Dolphins take a bite out of the Valley.
Great little slip ball through, run in between the two center backs, and a fantastic composed finish.
As cool as you like. Look at that. Just swims past the defense, takes the shot. Nothing Kabara could have done about it because, well, they have absolute reason to celebrate, don't they?
Absolutely. It's decisive strike, fantastic finish. It was cool, calm, collected. This is a fantastic ball through. Great finish. after Valley had been having most of the play.
Yeah, yeah.
Dolphins absorbing pressure.
And I think those players know it, how that tide had turned very quickly. Back to action, folks. It is 1-0 here in Irvine, California. The Dolphins are up. What can Valley do? Out to touch right now. And I mean, the entire sort of defense and offense worked really well together for the Dolphins. What can I tell you? I mean, we can talk about Medina. We can talk about Gordillo. Fantastic players for the Dolphins. But don't count out Valley. They know it's early days.
Absolutely. They've been putting a lot of pressure on. I don't think their confidence is going to drop too much.
So do you think the manager is going to just change it up a little bit, or is it just too soon right now? I mean,
I think it's too soon, and they've created some chances. So I think you just have to continue to plug away and do the things that you had planned to do from the outset.
Well, here come Valley right now. Good movement. Not getting a bit of space. It's 2-on-1. He gets past his mark. Pushed away, and it's a goal. No, it's still in play. And now it's a foul. Nope. That was interesting. That was an interesting turn of events right there. Quick start. Using the sides of the pitch very, very well. Both these teams. Leo now has the ball. Doing very, very well. And again, got to look at Medina, who's being a pest right now. He wants, obviously, more goals for his team. Dan, you can just see how tight the midfield players and the defenders are when they compress back. Just not giving any space to Valley when they're moving forward.
Yeah, absolutely. They're doing a really good job of keeping the lines compact and really making it difficult to play balls forward on the ground.
So here come Valley. They're going to try to find some space, try to exploit any kind of pocket that Dolphins are leaving. It's just not happening right now. It's a throw in. Just run out of space at this point. Throw in for Dolphins. You can see the fence for Valley, Rangel, and Montero doing a really good job. Here he comes. Look, just finds his player, and then just there's a quick counter, and the referee stops the play.
Saw an infraction there.
Yeah. And look at this. Why not? Why not?
Love that traveling support.
Yeah, enjoy it.
Giving some good energy here.
Yeah. Back to action, and look at this, trying to get the ball to the final third of the pitch. They're going to go ahead and do that. Dolphins now on the attack. Good movement. Surely a shot. He takes it. Bread and butter for that goalkeeper.
Oh. Yeah, really didn't get quite the strike that he wanted to on it, but
But he had time to turn and actually take the shot, which was, I think...
Right, Dolphins have been doing a good job of getting in behind the last few times of Valley's line.
There's a lob right there. Certainly he's going to wait for his teammates to come in. He's got to be smart right now. Takes on a player, finds someone who was slightly open but well defended by Dolphins, and gets the ball out of danger, but not quite yet. Here come again for a second time in 30 seconds, trying to do something with that. Here comes Valley, going to get into the box. Finds the one open player. He's now in the box. Surely a shot. No! Wow!
Wow. Fantastic ball to pick him out. Just couldn't get down on that thing.
I thought he was going to take the shot, but he found his player and...
Really, that was a really big chance for for Valley to get back right back into this right away.
And they're getting back into it again, Danny. Look at this. Certainly going to try something new there. Back to his teammate. Certainly there's two players in all black waiting in the box. And just didn't quite get there. Leon with a defensive duty for Dolphins. But here come Valley. They're not giving up. They know they got time, and here we playing very well, back and forth. Very content to
Dolphins doing a good job of keeping their lines tight and compact, forcing Valley to go probe around the outsides.
Leon with the ball. Campos doing well to get back to Rangel. Rangel's going to just lob it in there. Not quite where he was intended to go, but the All Blacks now have a bit of space. Look at this. Oh! Very well done. The defender didn't cut his fingernails this morning, his toenails this morning.
Yeah.
Who knows what would have happened.
Cheeky little look over the top with the scoop.
So far, so good. This is a lot better than the first 20 minutes, in my opinion, folks. And look at
absolutely.
That.
They're really they're getting after it.
Yeah.
Valley's looking to get in behind. Dolphins really playing tight and working well in transition.
Well, they're actually playing football rather than, you know, trying to wrestle, you know. We've seen some good football by both these teams in the past, and they're treating us to that right now. Taken away, but given back. Here come Valley. Very physical on both sets of players here. Pinned to the corner. Gets past one Dolphin. Oh. Well, certainly that's very easy to call there.
Absolutely. Kill the transition. But Dolphins are doing a really good job of getting multiple numbers around the ball when it's deep in their end, and that's really frustrating Valley, I think, on these times when they're really trying to isolate 1v1 wide.
And at one point, Valley have to just say, listen, there's not much I can do. I've got to foul him. We're in their area. I don't want it to go to our third of the pitch. And so it's a clever move.
Yeah, make him go through all 11.
Both managers very well versed, you know, when it comes to sort of being prepared for these matches. And you can kind of see it here. I can almost envision both of them of saying, look, calm down. They don't need to be. Let's just play our football. And now we're sort of seeing it. Here come Dolphins. Nicely done. Very well controlled. He's looking for his teammate. Can't find anyone yet. Now he does. Sly tackled away by Valley.
Dolphins having success, though, on that left side of the field. Winning second balls, little runs in behind. The goal came from that side.
Medina has to watch himself. He's getting into a lot of arguments. There it is. You gotta listen to the commentator once in a while, fellas. You got a little rush of blood to the head and that kind of nonsense. I just said, Medina, you gotta take it easy. This isn't a sixth sense that I have. You've seen this happen so many
multiple times.
Where
yeah.
It's like you get a little, you know, too much passion, and then suddenly head goes down and you're headbutting someone. I mean, you shouldn't have been doing that. I think he's going to get lucky, and the referee's not going to. He didn't even see it. So.
Hopefully, we can move forward and see some more good football. It's been the tempo has been good when it hasn't been stop start, and
the player that went down made a bit of a meal of it too. I can tell you that much. But it shouldn't be getting down to this. Come on, lads. Come on. Play the game. You guys are brilliant footballers. Let's play this game. And if, you know, if there was a VAR, this would have gone two Lickety people.
Split.
Yeah, been 10 on 10. And
on the referee has pulled out a red.
Yeah. Honestly, I think it. Yeah, it's now 10 versus 10. Yeah, he saw it, right? I'm sorry. Yeah, he saw it, and it's, you know, two key players are going to be off, and they're going to feel really bad tomorrow.
Yeah, letting their team down.
Yeah.
For sure. Letting their emotions get the best of them and letting their team down.
Yeah. Now they're mad at them, you know, the other team, and maybe mad at themselves, but, you know.
The referee's forced into this position.
Yeah. Right, right. So now what does the manager do now that, you know, is it take a, you know, is it now 4-4-1? You know, is it, you know, is it going to change to a lobbing game, like a long ball game at this point? What's going to happen? What do you think?
I don't know. I think that they're obviously they're going to need to make some kind of tactical adjustments as far as positions and things like that. But I feel like maybe now there'll be a bit more space, a bit more room to play, and we might see some of the best football yet.
Yeah, good point. That is something that I rarely think about. Like Zico and Adair and all the classic footballers from the Brazilian national team from 1982 always said that they played much better when there was one less player on the pitch
because
there was so much more space to work their Brazilian magic.
Yeah, so absolutely.
Could that happen here? Well, I mean, only time will tell, but great point.
That's what we're hoping.
Yeah, great point. I like that. See, now the referee has to also think about, like, listen, you know, has these two red cards calmed them down, or has it inflamed them even
incited them,
you know?
It's
continue. A thankless job, this refereeing. It really is.
Absolutely.
Can't play the game without them, but, you know. But, yeah, I think both these players that have been ejected are going to be gutted now and even more gutted tomorrow when, you know.
They couldn't be on the field to help their team.
You know? And it's really weird. Like I tell players, like, you're doing something that everyone in the stadium wishes they were doing. You know, you're playing a competitive match of football. Like, I want to be playing this game.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yep.
And now you just did something that now you're playing. Now you're out of it. I mean,
you took know. And the sad part is they took themselves out of it.
Yeah.
And didn't.
Yeah. Well. There's a bunch of like 50-year-old guys in the stadium. Like, oh, I wish I was playing right now.
Right.
You know, and then they see that, they go, oh, kid, what'd you do? The irony, the sad irony of getting old as a football player. Not you, I'm talking about me. like you kind of wish you were there on the field. And yeah.
Absolutely. And just being out in a stadium like this, it really it gets you excited.
Yeah.
Seeing the lines, seeing the grass, nice and short, balls traveling, it just looks... It makes you get excited and want to play.
Yeah. Well, Dino has to get off the pitch. And I know he's mad and he's furious and he's going to have a whole range of emotions. And believe me when I tell you, I wasn't always the Dalai Lama of soccer. I had those emotions and I was a rough player. And I, you know, try to take out kneecaps, you know. But at the end of the day, you got to get off the pitch and let your teammates get on with today's business. So back to action, folks. Throw in for the Dolphins. No free kick. Okay. Dolphins now have possession. Less of them. But then again, there's less of the Valley players as well.
Yep, yeah, we're going to see, you know, quite a bit more space. Maybe a little bit more room to run. It'll be up to the defensive lines to really make sure they're pushing up and keeping this field as compact as possible from a defensive perspective.
Most oftentimes they keep the two center backs, you know, in the back where they kind of belong. Here we go. Taken away. Quick counter. Can they do something with it? It's going to just very slow bounce. Dolphins have it now. So I was about to ask, do you just keep one center back and sort of push that other center back into the midfield a little bit. We'll see. It looks like certainly Valley's not doing that. Oh, tripped up. Oh, very well done. Here comes Valley and just taken away from the back, and he's going to get called. Technically a foul from behind.
Getting his foot in there. It looks like Valley dropped to one of the central midfielders into that line of four when they're defending, but I'd think that he'd push more into the midfield when they're in the attack.
Yep, good. Now that does change it up a little bit. Let's see how both the managers react to that. That's a nice ball. He's going to have to control it very, very well. Certainly something happened. Surely a shot, and well saved. It's not out of danger yet.
Wow, what a fantastic first touch with his chest in his stride. Great save in the end.
Ribeiro was so fast, and the amount of skill to control that, but it's not out of, and there's, look at that. Well, and here he comes again. Now they know he's dangerous. Now there's two players on him. Goes past one, goes past two, but not quite past the third one. And he's not giving up. How tenacious is this player? See it right over here.
Fantastic first touch in his stride. Keeper does well. Oh. Stands up, stays big. Good save.
Well, that would have just absolutely turned this game on its ear. The Dolphins now have the ball.
They're doing most of their work and damage here on the left side, right side of Valley.
And here comes Valley, looking to his right. A little bit of space, and there's a player in front of him. Rather than chooses to go a bit more direct into the box, but very well handled by the Dolphins. Looking. Any kind of strike on net right now, and it's on their side of the pitch, so here comes Valley. Oh, just miscommunication here. Gordillo has the ball, and he gets it to his teammate, and he's going to want to take a crack at it. He doesn't. Gets it backwards. Now you can see a lot of black shirts in the back just trying to defend. Ribeiro is even in the back right now defending. A little bit of a shirt tug. Well.
Got tired of that.
Yeah. Contreras was like, you can have my shirt when we're done. Yeah, at this point. I mean, they're nice shirts. They're good jerseys,
nice.
You know.
They're nice.
You can have it afterwards.
Nice trade after.
I need to wear it. I need to wear it right now. So.
Just a little impatient. That's
yeah.
All.
He's over the ball right now. Goes to his right. A little bit of action right now. Leon just boots it away. It's out to touch. I'm sensing that Valley's a little bit more nervous in the back right now with losing one man than the Dolphins, but that's more of a feeling than a proper sort of observation.
Yeah, well, I think maybe it for the Dolphins, losing a striker, attacking player at the top, maybe does a little bit less for their organization than losing a center back.
Ribeiro has... No. You can see Ribeiro's just like waiting for that bounce to see if a defender could handle it before he did anything with it. I think that split second. So I think all eyes on Ribeiro right now. Maybe he can get that equalizer.
Yeah, take advantage, pounce on a mistake. It's going to be really important for the Dolphins' back line to stay concentrated with them only having one up high.
Nice long throw in. There it is. Well defended. He's going to have to get just outside of their final third to do something with it. Maybe now. It's in the middle of the park. Here come Valley, staying on their feet. Very well done. Good little through ball, but... Goalkeeper had his eyes on it all the way. No problem. Referee's calling something. Yeah, it's a player physio needs to come out. So it's another few moments added on to the stoppage clock. And again, the stopping and starting, Danny, I mean, it's just, it can't be ideal to get any kind of runs of play or any kind of things going, right?
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard when the rhythm gets continually, you know, cut and cut and cut and cut with fouls or stoppages or balls out of play, things like that. It's hard to get a rhythm. It's hard to get some flow with your possession.
Do you think it's one team's plan or it's just?
I think there are some teams
that will go like, listen, we got to foul them to stop them getting any kind of movement. So.
Yeah, I don't think it's necessarily the game plan. I think it's more the way it's kind of worked out and the all the energy that the guys were bringing in the beginning of the game and how that kind of affects it and shakes out.
Yeah, we've seen plenty of matches where it was like these guys are way better than us. We just got to like foul them, bring them down, stop them from playing. You know, kick the ball away as soon as possible. Just cause a lot of chaos and disruption in their routine so we can get at least one or two. Sort of our plays together.
Yep.
Oh, here we go again. Oh, no, that's... no, that's a replay. I just don't think this should be the highlight.
No. No, there's so much more to this game than that.
I honestly thought it was another...
A replay. Yeah. Or deja vu.
Deja vu, yeah. Like, oh, something like that. Nice slide tackle and well done by Dolphins and just very, very tough football here. Not quite on the same page. He knows what he's doing. He wants to get it to his striker. Just overcooked it a little bit. And then he's all the way back from defending. Here come the Dolphins. A little bit of a give and go, but not quite. He's invited a defender to try to get him to open up some space. Maintaining possession. Bags of space to his left. Chooses not to do nothing. Okay, to the front. Oh, a little triangle game here. Back to the sides. And sort of given away. Here come Valley. And they're going to play that long ball, aren't they, all the time?
Yeah, Dolphins, I was just going to say, started to establish a little bit of a rhythm with their possession, but Valley really just hasn't been able to string four or five passes together on a consistent basis.
And looks like there's a bit of a hobble. Got a knock right over here. Look, he's not quite running correctly. Ribeiro doesn't look like he's not running quite as well as he did in the beginning.
Yeah, looking.
Watch him again. We'll see.
He maybe took a knock.
Yeah. So the half can't end too soon for him. Yeah, look. That's going to be something that Gaffer's going to have to contend with in the locker room. But on this side of the pitch, look at this. Dolphins now. A little bit of pressure. It's one-on-one. Oh, just toe-poked away.
Valley does a good job 1v1 defending in the box there. But Dolphins looking, having success getting in behind Valley on that left side of the field.
Pushed away. And there's a tumble. Six of one, half a dozen of the other, if you ask me. So referee's not doing anything. I don't know about you. I mean, it's for the neutral, this is sort of everything that, you know, sort of lower league football is about. It's tough. It's this, you know, moments of madness and moments of brilliance, skill,
absolutely,
passion.
It really has everything. It really has everything for the fan to watch. Some good football, some goals, definitely the passion.
The managers are sort of playing almost this weird chess match of like, we've got to do this, we've got to do this, and then they're thrown a loop. But, you know, back to action. There's that long ball. It's just not getting to anyone in a black shirt. Dolphins now have the ball. Easy now. Get to the center back. We've seen this sort of play before. Content to hold it on their side of the pitch. Now, here's that long ball. Completely bypassing the midfield, but again, going to...
Dolphins?
And, yeah, go. Sorry, go ahead, Danny.
No, I was going to say, Dolphins are satisfied sitting more in their mid-block, keeping the lines tight, making it difficult for Valley to play in between the lines. And they're having success with longer passes.
It would be nice for the neutral to have a goal going, another goal going into the heart, into the locker room. And it could happen. Is Ribeiro with the ball, keeps it in. He's going to get off the pass one mark. Now there's three players going to get off. Look at that. Nice. Look. Booted away. Ribeiro can't be provider and goal scorer, so we'll see what happens in the second half. Here comes
his third tackling. He's dangerous every time he gets it.
Yeah.
Gets isolated.
Yeah. And he's just worked his socks off the entire half. He's going to need a break. He's going to need the physio to look at him. He's going to... Yeah, he's...
He's definitely been Valley's most dangerous player.
But he's literally begging the referee to call halftime because he's just so tired. And kudos to him. He's got a fan out of me because he's just a hard-working player. There we go. Few moments left. Looking to his left. He sees his... Goes down the middle. Can he save it? And...
Good job driving at the space, taking that on the dribble, opening up the game, and finding a ball in behind.
And we are getting probably dying moments of the first half, a corner kick that could, if done correctly, change a lot of things. Ribeiro has the ball. He's looking to Leon. He's going to try to get it to his defender. Defender's running up really close. There he is. Smart. Smart play. In the box. There you go. And a header in! And it's, oh my word.
Wow, what a fantastic ball in. Great header moving away from goal. Wow, how he was able to get that amount of power on it moving away from goal was fantastic.
And on the other side of the pitch, something just happening and just end-to-end stuff. I think that hit the crossbar.
It was nice.
Oh my word.
Really nice header. Good ball in. Playing it short, bringing Dolphins out from... the box a little bit, creating a little bit more space, and a good late ball in.
Not giving up. Here come Valley. Just looking for the right player to get it to. So far, so good. String of passes that are absolutely positive. Back to defense. Can't find anyone to make that run. Here's that nice through ball, and just well defended from the midfield. And here come Dolphins and kicked away.
Poor execution and transition. Those are the moments to go.
And speaking of moments to go, there's only a few moments to go in this half, Danny, and the Valley are trying to get into the box by hook or by crook, trying to get to anyone in a black shirt, slide tackle, and... Well, dearie, dearie me. Certainly there was contact, ref.
With the way the game's gone, I'm surprised the ref didn't show yellow there.
He's gonna have I'm not gonna be surprised if the ref goes into the locker room at halftime and says, "Calm down, guys.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you don't want an 8-on-8 game here. You don't want a 7-on-7 game here. You know, it would be interesting, but I don't think it
would be interesting. And there's a lot at stake here, right? This is a national quarterfinal, but really. I think both teams can get their emotions into check just a little bit more.
And I'm not going out on a limb, Danny, by saying both these teams deserve to be here.
Yeah.
You know, they both, the way they're playing, we can feel the passion and and right here, defender going straight into the box looking for his teammate. Dying moments in the first half, and anything could happen at this point. Another red. Two fouls in a row, a goal. And here you go. Look at this. Look at this. No.
Ambitious attempt.
Yeah. Well, very clever. He saw saw the goalkeeper off his line, and why not? Definitely, if it went in, it was a highlight.
Absolutely.
Real moment. Here comes Ribeiro with the ball. Gets past his mark. And
he really creates danger every time he gets it. It's good to see him come inside with it, too.
Seems like there's like one, two, three, four, like six defenders in the back for Dolphins at this point.
Yeah, they get a lot of numbers, a lot of bodies behind.
Ooh.
Really make it difficult for Valley to play through.
Now, that was a slide tackle with studs up, and the referee gave it to the tackler with the studs up. That's interesting. We're going to see that. No, we'll just see this one instead. That's much better. No.
Good header.
Wow.
Good header.
Some days when you're commentating, you just turn into a fan.
Oh, yeah,
absolutely.
These
are one of the matches where I'm like, I'm just enthralled of both with both these teams and how well they play, and a little bit of a dark arts going on over there. Yeah. Here comes Ribeiro now. They know he's dangerous. That's one player. He bypasses it, gets it into the box somehow. He's got to control. There's no one there. His teammate was looking to see if him closer by, but as a good player does, he's running back to defend just in case. But okay, the fans have stopped, the players are still firing on full cylinders, going on 51 minutes. Oh, very well done. There you go. Good movement. In the box. Can he get past his mark? He does. Taken away, and they're still scrambling for the ball. Referee's going to call something. Who's it to? Well, it's a free kick. Very dangerous. Can Valley do something with this?
One of the few times they've been able to penetrate through the middle on the ground. It's a good play from Valley. Good sequence.
I mean, goalkeepers all the way into the center spot. Center back is in the midfield. Everyone's in the box almost. Ribeiro has the ball. He's going to go ahead and just try to get it floated in there. Wow.
Dangerous ball. Just a little bit high to get redirected. The goalkeeper does a good job to come out and take it in.
I mean, the sheer, like, cheek of Ribeiro, like, everyone's in the box. Everyone's waiting for a header. And he goes, no, I'm going to go ahead and just curl it in there.
Not a bad effort.
No, and if I was the manager, I'd be like, yeah, okay.
All right, I'm okay with that.
Yeah, talk about surprise. Here come Valley trying to get the ball, trying to keep the ball. Working very hard.
Dolphins doing a good job getting a lot of numbers around the ball defensively, making it really difficult for Valley.
Surely a shot. Surely a cross now. Something. No, just wants to hold on to it just for a split second too long. Dolphins now have that counter. It's going to be floated ball. And out of danger and quickly back on the pitch.
Valley doing a much better job of not letting the Dolphins get in behind him, especially on that left side.
And there you have it, folks. And, well, if you think this has been a very strange match to call, I would absolutely agree. We've seen everything. Right now, here in Irvine, California, Valley 0, the Dolphins 1. My name is Simon Allen. I'm the Dalai Lama of soccer. Next to me, Danny Califf. Lads are going into the locker room, and I don't know if I would want to be a fly on the wall on any of those.
It's going to be an interesting conversation the coaches have. I think they're going to be making some tactical adjustments, but also just, I think, speaking to the energy level and making sure that they're able to keep it at an intense level without going overboard.
I would say if I was a manager, I'd be on the borderline of yelling and hairdryer treatment.
quite possibly, yeah.
Some of those tackles, you're really taunting that referee to pull out a card.
Absolutely.
But we'll see. We've seen matches that have been night and day when it comes to halves.
Absolutely. Yep.
So we'll give them the 15 minutes, and TV Max will give us 15 minutes to take a break. And folks, stay tuned. We'll be back soon.
Thank you. Hello? 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 You hear me? Try this.
Test, test, test.
Oh, I can hear you. Yeah. Put it on. Test, 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 test. Can you hear me, Noah? Testing, testing. Hello?
Help? You can help.
Yeah. Yes.
Test.
Yeah, I hear you.
What number did I just say? Two.
I can't hear you when you whisper.
What number? Put up a number two if you can hear me. Put up five fingers if you can hear me. Put up nine fingers if you can hear me.
Oh, you can hear.
Yeah, I can hear.
I can hear.
How do we fix that?
It's not loud, but I can't hear you. Test, test, test. Can you hear me, Noah?
Wait, one more time.
Testing, testing, testing.
Oh, that's so quiet.
Yeah, it's super quiet. Oh, that's, I can hear a lot.
You can hear?
Yeah.
Talk.
Testing, testing, testing. Hello, 1, 2, 3, testing. You
test,
can hear?
Test, test, test.
I can hear.
Okay.
Test,
test.
We back.
And welcome back, folks. Simon Allen here, the Dalai Lama of soccer. Next to me, Danny Califf. Between the two of us, I think we've had 26 caps for the United States national team in
about
six games.
Yeah.
And so, you, what are you at, 26? I'm at zero?
Well, something like that.
What a way to inflate the resume, right, Danny?
Really?
Between the both of us, we have 26.
You know.
We're having a great time here in Irvine, California. We've witnessed a very interesting match to where I would say it has everything. Like, if you're writing a book about a match, whatever, it has two red cards. It has some, you know, a little bit of dark arts going to it. It has very rough football. It has one goal. And it has two teams that are not putting their foot off the accelerator.
Absolutely.
Playing tougher as the first half was going on. And now we're going to watch them come out of the locker room wondering what the two gaffers said to them. If it was, what the heck are you guys doing? Play football, or more of the same, please. We can win it this way. So what do you think? I mean, again, purely speculation. What do you think there was going on in the locker room?
I think it was a little bit of both. I think that there was certainly mention of the fact that they have to keep their tempers in check, but also there's some good quality attacking football from both sides. So
let's see what happens. Referee blew the whistle for the second half. We're on the second half. We're here in beautiful Irvine, California. This is the first time I've ever been in a situation where it's been muggy and hot like this. I think it could be a bit weird for the players on the pitch. The ball has gone into the stands. So, again, new stuff for me, because I've never seen this happen where the player has gone into the stands for in a match in this stadium. Quick throw-in for Valley. Now, Valley has to essentially be in double speed because they're a goal down.
Absolutely. They're going to be really pushing and really, I think, want to set the tone early.
Right now, the Dolphins have it. Again, it's just very physical football. I would have to say, with all due respect, it looks like, to me, sort of like the 70s style, sort of second division football that I sort of watched when I was a kid. But I say that with all due respect because they were tough and it was good.
Good
and
football,
it sort of reminds me of this. There are a few players on the field that are very capable of playing some Jogo Bonito, some beautiful football. So we want to see that. Right now, the looks like very happy both these teams just to pass the ball around and see what's going on. Find those pockets. Here we go. Here is Valley. They got the ball. Going to get past the Dolphins defense. They're not doing it. It's a foul. Referee says no. Into the box. No one in there. Remember, folks, it's 10-on-10. Booted away. That's what I would have probably done. It's coming straight to me, folks. There you go. Did you hear that? Literally, I could take that ball. There we go. Now, this is interesting. There we go. And by the way, this is why I love UPSL football. I love UPSL soccer. UPSL soccer, because when you come and watch these matches, Danny, you've been in the stadium before. You and I have worked here before.
Yeah.
You're part of everything.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
You could be in the stands, and you're two seats away from where we are right now, or you're two seats away from the players. I mean, I always joke that if I was any closer, I'd have to wear a jersey.
It really is a beautiful place and a great place to come and enjoy a game.
Like I've been saying for many years, it's the only thing that really is missing is you. So next match, hopefully I'll see you all here. I want to thank the TV Max family for broadcasting this as well as we're on YouTube. Here come Valley, and black and gold. Choose to go to the center of the park. A little bit of space available. Dolphins aren't really doing much to go ahead and do anything in that part of the park. Here comes as a defender on the fantastic.
Good run in. Committed a couple defenders, slid right past, just couldn't keep it under the bar. But Valley doing a good job coming out of the half with some good energy, especially down their left hand side, and it'll be interesting to see how the Dolphins react to that.
Montero just sort of laid back a bit rather than putting his head over the ball to keep the ball down, but that was a bit dangerous. That sort of came out of nowhere. Hernandez with the ball, kicks it. Defense content, taking it back to his teammate. Cabarro gets it back to his defender. A little bit of space, but he's going to get caught. I mean, dare I say he's going to go back to the goalkeeper, but it's not. Switches sides of the field. Back to the center back. Dolphins content not to really put any pressure while it's in that side of the pitch. Remember, it's 1-0, and Valley does have to score. This is the national quarterfinals. Now, here's a little bit of an attack. Bypasses the midfield, sort of. Doesn't get past the first defender, and Dolphins very content to just boot it away. Chested down. Montero doing a good job. Making himself available, but he's on the left-hand side. They don't quite see him. Fresh legs on the pitch for Valley. And just not
just
falling
ran away
way.
From
yeah.
him.
Interesting first few moments of this match where both these teams stringing a good number of passes together.
Yep.
Being patient, being skilled, and none of that sort of,
none of the physicality yeah. that we started yeah. the first half with. Yeah. So
I wonder how long that'll last.
Yeah.
Here we go, folks. Back to action on the Valley side of the pitch. And again, very well done. The defenders have been given instruction to move the ball from side to side. Obviously, anything with less green shirts, that's where they will go. Down the middle of the park right now. Valley with the ball, content. Look, this is a very long string of possession, which is good. Here come Valley. Certainly something happening. Not enough bodies on front right now because there wasn't enough players up front to make that kick, and here he goes. That's what we wanted to see about a second ago and didn't quite connect. Not on the same page of his teammates. Here come the Dolphins right now. Good movement. And there's that little space between the midfield and the defense that Dolphins can exploit, but absolutely grabbed away by Valley, who are content just to move it from side to side. Very well done. Middle of the park right now.
And you see how Dolphins have kind of dropped into more of a little bit more of a 4-4-1 or even a 5-3-1 here to kind of deal with Valley and their repeated attempts yeah. to get him behind.
Looks like Flores for Valley is just getting that ball and just getting it to anyone up front. So we'll see what happens there. I'm sure Dolphins will figure out that he's the go-to guy at this point. But definitely a change of plan that we can see, you know, in the first 6 minutes of the match, or the second half, I should say. So here come bags of space for Valley. Sees his teammate, and look at that. And you are, Danny, you're absolutely right. That one less player has opened up a lot of space, and the passes are getting there. The dribbling is there. It's one-on-one right now. Very well done. Surely across into the area, and absolutely meat and potatoes for that goalkeeper. Didn't really bother him.
Just right in between two players there.
Montero, excuse me. I'll get his name right soon. Was there definitely, Danny, to try to make something happen. Montero. We'll talk to him after the game.
Figure it out.
I'm a big fan, so of all these players. But so far, so good. It's, to me, you can probably tell I'm a bit more excited about the second half as I was the first, so I'm glad you out there in the worldwide spiderweb have tuned back in. Thank you for tuning in. We're on YouTube, UPSL. Got to go also thank Del Real Foods, who was really nice during the halftime. Had their food out and so on and so forth, so thank you to our sponsors that way.
Valley still looking to hold Dolphins in, contain, and keep the pressure on here. Dolphins are doing a good job, though, staying organized, keeping their lines tight, and making it difficult for Valley to play through.
And Danny, look at this. I mean, Valley just going straight ahead, going forward into that Dolphins box, getting past defenders that last at the first half, they weren't really quite doing that very well. Look at this. First of all, he's got it. Pass it to his teammate. There he is. Surely a cross. Montiero just absolutely all over the park and doing just amazing stuff for his team. He's going to get past his marker. No, he doesn't.
Ooh. Valley doing a good job in the counter press, getting things going.
And I think maybe we spoke too soon, Danny, on the on the dark arts, so to speak. This is not good. I mean, Campos is a pivotal player. He's got a yellow. Now he's playing with a yellow. Montiero is literally trying to talk his way out of a yellow, which never happens. And we've got a player down for the Dolphins, which, again, really, this wasn't really needed, was it? Look. Yeah. You had possession.
I don't know if it's inadvertent or not, but...
So now another little bit of a stop and start. We had some good flowing football, and now it's stopped. And again, I'm not frustrated, but when you've seen good football for 20 minutes, you want to see that, you know, for the remainder of the match.
And this really just kind of kills the rhythm of the game.
Yeah. One thing I love about football is there's not really much standing around.
Right.
And now we've got a lot of standing around. So back to action, folks, I hope. Long ball to the midfield. Has to be controlled. Dolphins just let it slip away. It's out to touch. Throw in for Valley. Not too much of a rush. Montiero throws it in. It's back to his defenders. They're doing very, very well. Good movement. Tries to find anyone in a black shirt and well
good
done.
Recovering
yes.
Header back by the
great
Dolphins
job.
There.
Tandara with a running leap headed back to his goalkeeper. Just all over the park there, Montiero, isn't he? He's just all over the park. Back.
Forward, back.
Yeah. Given the way, though, and this is very dangerous. Chested down. Surely something's going to happen here. And well smothered by the defense for Valley. Just got in the way. And the goalkeeper, all had to do was just step forward and grab that ball. Crisis averted. And here come Valley, possibly with a quick counter. All right, I'll take that back. A semi-quick counter. And there's that long ball. He's going to find his teammate, certainly. Oh.
Did well to get up and redirect that down, but couldn't find a teammate.
More shirt tugging. Would have liked to have seen that, the forwards for Valley just let that ball go behind him and make a little quick turn and run into it. I don't think... look at this. Just well controlled right there. It's one-on-one. Dolphins have the ball. Slightly
see
over.
What he was trying to do there, but just couldn't keep it down and pick out that far post.
But how about just that smart delivery to his feet to where he could have just...
Yeah, it was just feathered, cultured ball in.
Yeah.
It was really nice.
All started from the midfield. Exciting stuff so far here in Irvine. It's 1-0. Dare I say, I don't think it's going to remain 1-0. But I just couldn't say... one way or the other, if it would be 2-0 or 1-1. Certainly not going to remain 1-1 if it does. Second half, national quarterfinals here in Irvine, California. It's 1-0. The Dolphins do have that edge. And
definitely well. Spoke too soon.
You know, maybe we shouldn't even talk about, you know. So next 20 minutes, complete silence from the commentating crew.
Yeah. How about that? Yeah. No, Dolphins seem just to be getting frustrated that they're having a hard time at getting out of their own end.
But they've been doing a splendid job getting the ball, sort of just lobbing it into, you know, outside. You know,
yeah,
they've
created danger in transition, but just consistently sitting so deep, they end up chasing a lot.
And another foul right over here.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I'm going to safely predict another card. Here we go. Some action. Can he keep it inside? No, for his efforts. Valley well done, does though. Get a corner kick.
Well done. Good control along the line and smart play to play it off the defender. It's a good opportunity for Valley to bring the big boys up and put the ball in the box.
Floated in.
Good delivery.
And here's that quick counter that we know the Dolphins can do. It's literally 2-on-1 right now. Valley defender scrambling to get back. It's 3-on-2. And he's going to get up and try and do something. And no, it's a foul. It's a foul, and it's going the other way.
Too much in the end. He's got to play that early ball so he can run in behind.
He was being a bit too selfish holding it.
I think he was waiting for the right moment to open up, but... the closer he gets to the goal, the harder it is to play that ball in behind. The space keeps closing up.
And here we go. It's end-to-end. It's bomb-burning stuff. We just need a goal. Here come the... And well done by Dolphins.
Good defensive play.
Yeah. Leon has been fantastic in the back. He has been a rock most of the time. Choosing to go backwards rather than forwards. We can see that happening. There's two center backs right now. There's a lot of space between them for Valley, and he's not going to get that ball. Campos needs to be closer to the action. But here come Valley. He's going to have to get it to Campos right now. And that just didn't quite do it, because here comes a speedy counterattack by the Dolphins. He's taking too much time. Now almost the entire team is running backwards. Stays on his feet. Well done to the Dolphins players. Goes.
Good run here.
Brazilian-like dribbling. I love it. This is what we were talking about in the first half. Yeah. A lot of space, so a lot of dribbling. Here come the Dolphins.
Doing well to exploit that space, but maybe too many touches in the end. Not really able to carve open Valley's defense.
Here come the Dolphins right now, Danny. And look, he's just trying to hold on to it. Why is he not taking the shot? But it's amazing stuff. I mean, it's...
Good
the dribbling
there.
Alone,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Created a dangerous opportunity for his team.
Wasn't this what we wanted to see all along?
Absolutely. Good, entertaining, confident stuff.
Now, here's a little bit of a dangerous position to sort of relinquish possession, and it's a free kick. Just about every player that's in All Black is going to be in that area and in the box. The camera can't see this, but there's a fan talking to the assistant referee, trying to, like, I don't know, give him pointers. But here come the Dolphins. They're in charge right now. Three of them standing over. And it's just not going to happen today like that. Just not going to happen. I was expecting Gordillo to do that, but... Excuse me. I was expecting Gordillo to take the shot, not do that. But
yeah.
Pardon me. But wasn't going to... bother the goalkeeper.
In the end, a wasted effort. But it's showing that the Dolphins have opportunity in transition. If they can counter quickly and get a few more numbers forward, they create problems for Valley.
I'm going to go out on the limb, Danny, and just say that both these teams are playing better 10-on-10 than they were 11-on-11, don't you think?
100%.
Yeah?
100%. There's... just much more flow to the game. They're able to connect some passes and get into a rhythm.
They're still fouling.
Still that.
So they haven't
still that. Maybe less because there's less players.
Yeah.
But
less crowded.
Right. A little less crowded. Can't be as close to people. But
no. But I think it's I'm enjoying.
It's
the,
not
I'm
with
the
same intensity as in the first half, and a lot less communication with the referee and.
Well, now we have the fans talking to the referees,
right,
which I think is brilliant, and which is why I want everyone to come out here. This is what you can see, what you can experience here in Irvine, California. This is a beautiful championship stadium. Ontario over the ball. No, he chooses to get it to his teammate. Doesn't get past the first defender.
And here, Dolphins out in quick transition if they can get the ball forward early.
And they're doing it. Gordillo just does a great job getting it, but it's just not on the same page as his teammate, which is very much a shame. So far, so good. And these passes are just fantastic. And it really does remind me of the passes that were like, that were made, and I'm going to get so many emails about this one, but let me take the shot first. I see these passes that were, like, it reminds me of like when I was a kid and I watched, you know, the 82 Brazil team, you know, at the World Cup. They made these just beautiful passes into space and they were doing it. And again, this is what I like about football, is that, you know, these sort of movements, the team moves together and passes beautifully and knows where every other teammate is on the pitch. That's what I'm kind of seeing over here, which is a lot better than what was going on in the first half.
Absolutely. They're much more coordinated in the way that they're moving and together and in sync and timing. It's definitely, the second half has definitely allowed them to play a little bit more free and flowing.
And from all sides of the pitch, you see them passing from one end to the next and then back again. So it is that flowing football. We've got a couple of subs coming in. Rodriguez coming off. So far, so fresh legs. I mean, definitely about the time that you would see that. Then go back to the football. All right, back to action. All right, well done.
Just couldn't get enough on it to keep that one in. Valley take control here.
Well, it's amazing how I think the goalkeeper just said, well, why not just get it to Gordillo? Let's like get it straight to him so he can do it rather than having that sort of cutoff player. Like, let's play then Gordillo. Just get it straight to him and see what he does. Just working his socks off. And the more you look at these players, Danny, the more you become fans of them. You know, they're doing a really good job.
Absolutely. Putting in a lot of hard work during the week, and this is really a showcase of their talents.
Going. Throw it going for Valley. One. Nice. Very clever. Just admiring the passing at this point. Come on, just get it. Go on then.
Dolphins really aggressive defending in the area, really committed to try and get bodies in front of the ball and stop forward progress.
You saw that run up, Danny, where it was just like 3-4 passes, and then the forward had to sort of muscle his way through 3 different defenders, and he's furious at himself. But that's the kind of stuff that I think sort of the takeaway from this is that just how the football is much better, you know, in this half. And just good movement, just understanding the space around them, just 100% better than the first half. And
yep.
And we've got a player down and a yellow card. Well, I predicted that. I wasn't going to go out on a limb, but I did. I mean, we're halfway done in the second half. And it's been end-to-end stuff. Waiting for a free kick for the Dolphins.
They're in no hurry to take it, get things done there.
Taking sweet time. There it is. Montero now with the ball. To his teammate.
Difficult ball floated in for him. Valley's doing a good job of challenging every ball in the air and winning
clean
those
challenges.
Balls. Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
There's a stark difference, right, between the first and the second half. We were here ready to talk about how it's going to get rougher and more gritty in the second half, and it's become just more rhythmic and fluid in the second
fluid
half.
And elegant. Yeah. All right.
Rhythmic, and of course the traveling fans with their drums Definitely helping with that rhythm, right?
Definitely helping with the rhythm, that's for sure. Keeping the energy in the stadium high.
There we go. There's that. There it is. Certainly going to have to do something with it. He's going to have to control it now. No. Just gets past him. Saw what he could do. Ooh. Good. Well done here. He knows he just passed it to his left.
Again, Valley doing a good job of snuffing out Dolphins' attacks early in their half. Football.
There we go. Certainly someone's going to have to have an end before he... Oh, well, just tough defending. Throw in very quickly into the box, and there is... Wow. Not so. Back again. Got to admire the spirit of Valley and the players. No. Did he just set himself up for a bicycle kick?
I was waiting for it.
Oh, my goodness.
Definitely pulled out in the end. Dolphins do a good job of getting ahead on that.
Very well done. And Dolphins just working their magic in defense. And, yeah. I mean, that was an intelligent foul if there ever was one. Stop it right there.
Yep.
Now it's just weird when you see a player and he's just teeing up for a bicycle kick and then he doesn't have... It's almost like...
Wait, where was that? Oh, yeah.
You almost made the whole city explode, but you didn't. Yeah.
Again, Valley doing a really good job defensively on these long, direct balls from Dolphins.
Good movement. Looks behind him, doesn't see much trouble. Gets it to his teammate. Just classic football right now. It's 1-on-1, 2-on-1 right now. The longer he waits, the more trouble he's going to be. He gets past his marker. Certainly something's going to happen. For his efforts, he's going ahead and getting a throw-in. Now, this could be very dangerous. They've been insisting for at least 20 minutes. Here comes a dangerous player right now. They're giving him a lot of respect. Back to that. Look at that. And there's that cross. And the leg comes out. Yeah, stick your leg out. It does the job.
Good defending. Good defending out early to block the cross. Dolphins really committed to making sure that they keep it tight and do a good job defensively.
Leon just boots it out here, but you know what? It's something else on the flip side of that, Danny. Valley's not letting Dolphins breathe at this point. They're just going in. It's just a bottle of that. That's not going to... Oh! No. Ooh. No, that's just... That's hard to see.
It's just silly.
I mean, you got to protect the goalkeeper, I understand. And that would have been a great goal, but... Oof. You got to take a look at this. I mean, there's a nice cross. And then... Yeah. Well, we got a goalie down, and that means we've got about at least a two-minute break on this one. He needs to be looked at. Physio does need to come out with the goalie, but he... Wow, what a trooper. Referee's having a few words with the Valley player. And
it's a tough one. You'd like to think that they both have an ability to challenge for it.
Yeah, you have every right to do it, and I get it. But, wow, that looks... Well, it looks a lot worse than it was, I'm sure.
Yeah, thankfully.
Yeah. Here comes... Well, I mean, while there's a sort of a, while we're here, Danny, what do you think about like these folks who are like, we shouldn't have heading in football?
I don't buy that.
Well, no, I don't either. But do they have a point? I mean, well, certainly it would be change the game forever.
I think it would change the game forever, most certainly. But yeah. I think that we need to maybe as a culture and. Community start teaching heading
properly yeah
and then before we decide to ban it.
I've seen coaches that have 20-30 little students and they're teaching them heading and there's a certain age you have to teach them, not you can't do anything, and they've been doing it wrong, and I sort of go, wow, this is a bit weird. I can see both sides of it. But it's just, you know, it's always a conversation to have. I'm betting right now everyone on Twitter is having a thought about that. So we'll just leave it out on the Twitterverse.
Yeah, throw it out there. I really do believe that if you can teach heading, that it can still be part of the game.
We're in the box right now. Thankfully, no one's hurt. Here's a shot on goal. Just Dolphins are putting their body out there, making sure nothing gets passed. Good movement. Valium maintaining possession. Bags of space. There's that little ball that we're looking for. It's going into the box, and goalkeeper's going to easily handle that. Oh.
Dolphins bending but not breaking.
Certainly, I'm just sort of back to that sort of heading thing. The football, if you brought someone back from the past that, you know, who haven't seen football in the past 20 years, it wouldn't definitely not, he wouldn't recognize it, would he?
You know, well,
pass back rule and
yeah, I think so. Like so much has changed and the game has really evolved.
VAR, you
know. Yeah, the game has really evolved and you know, it's different. I think that there's something to be said for all the iterations that come before it. But we're at a new time in the game, and the requirements on the players are different.
While we were talking, obviously, good little movement by the Dolphins, just muscled away by Valley. Well, I'm very thankful that football's around.
Me too. Me too. It brings joy to my life.
Valley just very happy to move the ball around from side to side. Just switching sides. Montero now has the ball. He gets fouled. There's a lot of movement going on that side of the pitch, mostly due to Montero being there. Someone saying that it was an offside. Okay, fair enough. It was. Dolphins now have the ball. He's waving on the players on the sides of the pitch. They move forward. We don't need you that many people on this side of the pitch. Tend to agree with him. There's two target men up front for Dolphins. They haven't got the ball yet. Here comes Montero. He's got the ball. Gives it away. And this is dangerous, but it's 2-on-3 right now. 2-on-4. And very content to just hold the ball.
Valley doing a good job of getting numbers back, making sure that every Dolphin attack is met by equal to outnumbered situation.
Oh, this is a Dolphin just being a pest at this point going up there, but he's going to have to get it out. There you go. Got to get to the final third. He does. It's just not on the same page as his forward, but it was definitely there. He's giving the thumbs up.
Oof. Oh, goodness.
Oh! Okay, I'm not going to comment on that. But here's the shot, certainly. Oh, unlucky for Montero. He's been everywhere. And if there's anyone that you would expect a goal from, it would be him.
Yeah, he's been a danger man for Valley, that's for sure. Getting up and down the line. Good engine. Good quickness when he gets it.
I would be really not doing my job if I didn't have to, didn't say, that was a two-footed lunge tackle.
Wow.
From the defense.
I'm just very happy he didn't connect with
anything. Yeah,
that could have been ugly.
Yeah. It's like Shades of Vinnie Jones from 1988 or something. You know what I mean? So
that could have been.
People could be Googling that in a minute now. Like, what's he doing? It's like, hey. You got to go back. Go back that far.
Last time I saw a tackle like that.
It was 1980.
Yeah.
Might be a flashback to what I played. You know, you never know. So it wasn't. I wasn't that bad. Just runs out to touch at this point, which is fine. Goalkeeper has his ball. He's going to go ahead and kick it.
Valley's going to want to get it into play. right away, continue their pressure.
I mean, it's 12 minutes to go. Would you be putting your thumb over the panic button, Danny?
No, but I want to start to move numbers forward.
Yeah.
Put more guys along the front line. And
do you really need two center backs in the back?
I don't think so.
At this point,
actually. Not at this point. Yeah. I think that you can play a 2-versus-1 and allow your outside backs to really push forward and kind of join.
Also, if you're playing this long ball in, you're going to need more targets at least, right?
Absolutely. So, and guys around for the second ball.
So we'll see what happens. Both these gaffers are not really panicking at this point. They've changed the way they're playing in the second half, but they're not really doing anything drastic. So,
yeah, it'll be interesting to see how. I think we're going to see the same thing out of the Dolphins. They're going to keep their lines tight and sit deep and really look to frustrate Valley. And it's going to be interesting to see how Valley goes about trying to dismantle that organization.
Isn't that dangerous, though, if you sort of like sit back and if you pull one back, for example, it becomes 1-1.
It's really hard to get the momentum back.
I see. Yeah. Yeah. So Dolphins when now. I'm sorry, Danny, go ahead.
No, I was just saying, when you've been sitting deep and absorbing and holding a lead, if you lose it, it's really hard to then come out of that shell and really start attacking.
Yeah. But they've been near flawless, in defense most of the time, right? Suddenly, to say there'd be a gigantic mistake that would turn this game into a, 1-1 draw, I'll definitely be going out on a limb by saying that. But we've seen weirder things in football.
Absolutely.
Here comes...
That's why we love football.
Yeah, exactly.
All sorts of crazy things can happen.
Well, it's a foul right now. Dolphins have the ball. You're going to go ahead and right now you're going to see everyone in a black shirt go into the box other than maybe one who's be tiptoeing on the halfway line. Most of the players right now, it's very odd. There's like three defenders for the Dolphins just laying back. So
they've been doing a lot of running defensively. These guys are probably just trying to get their air, making sure they keep things tight.
And here we go. Look at that. Very quickly done. No. Sorry, folks. Referee didn't blow the whistle. Sorry, Danny.
That was a good little look over the top. It was a good little look over the top.
Sometimes we forget these aren't gladiator robots. They're actually humans. They need to get air and water and something like that.
Yeah. Not just machines, not robots.
Not yet. Maybe, in 100 years.
Maybe then we'd be watching some version of that.
And, we still need VAR.
We would still.
Here comes Montiel with all. We've seen him before. He's got it to his teammate. Just booted away by the Dolphins, as you would expect them to do in the 82nd minute of a match. That's one where they're 1-0 up in beautiful Irvine, California. It went from a little rain and mugginess to now it's almost perfect.
Gorgeous sunset. Fantastic out here. Fantastic venue to watch a game, and the weather's really turned out to be nice.
It's just my favorite venue, to be honest with you. It takes me back to my youth, to where the football was right in front of you, and you could almost shake hands with the players that were playing, and it's amazing. And I want everyone to come out there. If you're in the SoCal or OC area.
Definitely worth a drive out.
Oh, yeah. I know I make the drive, so it's definitely worth it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, here comes Montero with the ball. Gets it to his teammate. He gets fouled for his efforts. Right now, they have the ball. Very well done. It gets into the box. No one there yet. Dolphins have to get rid of that ball. They do. It doesn't go too far. Here come Valley. There's players in the box, and just Dolphins working their socks off. So far, so good. They got the ball. Montero to the side. He's got the ball right now. It's 3-on-1. Look. Just Dolphins stick their leg out.
Doing well to close those spaces.
Yeah.
Valley really probing the Dolphins' defense now, trying to find an opening.
And offside for And no rush to get the ball back either. We've got about 7 minutes, you know, give or take a few, you know, minutes of stoppage time, maybe 10 minutes. I'm still not convinced it's a 1-0 game. Very well could be. There's another goal somewhere lurking around here.
More conversations.
Interesting. Tobia. I don't know what's going on here. Oh. Oh, just he had just come on as well.
I was just going to say, I wonder if that's an injury or maybe he's, they don't want him to throw out another criminal tackle.
I have to say that. I think the manager was like, yeah, especially when we're so close to winning and heading to the semifinals.
Yeah.
I remember you weren't a softie on the pitch either, Danny. Come on now. You were pretty tough.
Well, that might have been a rather large part of my game.
As we get older, we get wiser.
That we do.
Well, I just hope that the folks out there who are watching this on YouTube at the very least understand just how much fun we're having watching this, and if it translates well through your YouTube screen, that you can come out and watch some UPSL soccer. You know, just watch it in your neighborhood. If you're in our neighborhood, of course come to OC. Goalie's not going to have any problem with that. And watch some football. If you've got a UPSL team in your neighborhood, go out and watch it, because it really is fun. You know, and I hope that, you know, you hear myself and Danny talking and just see how fun it is, and it gets you sort of motivated to come out into the stadium and support your local team. I've always said we've got some amazing football on TV right now, don't we, with the Women's World Cup.
Absolutely.
You can watch globally, but supporting locally is where it's at. And I think that's what I've always wanted to say about, you know, when we do these broadcasts, it's all about getting you over here to watch it and enjoy it the way, at least I enjoy it, you know? And it'll be fun to see you anyway. It'll be fun
to see everyone. Absolutely. And these athletes train really hard all year, and this is really good opportunity for fans to see, get up close and personal with live action.
And I'll be honest, if you are a parent or you're a kid and you're into football, this is the best place to come. Because your kids will see their heroes on the pitch, and they'll talk to them, and they'll take photos with them, and it's amazing. And if you can't, that's slowly going away everywhere else in the world, but in the UPSL and low league football, it's still here. It's why I love it.
It's so accessible.
Yeah.
And it's really a great platform for these young players.
We got about 5 minutes, give or take. Only the referee knows, obviously. Both these teams, well, they're not giving up. Here come Valley. Lots of good passing right now. Bags of space. Monterio now has the ball. He wants this ball. If anyone's going to make something happen, it's going to be him. Nice little cross into the area. Certainly something, a little bit of a push. He's going to have to get past his mark. We've seen this many times. He's not going to be able to get past his mark. Or could this be the time he does? Here come Valley. There's that cross. There you go. There it is. And, well, just swatted away like a big bear by the goalkeeper.
Great job coming out. Adjusting to the big looping ball flight.
Not out of danger yet, Danny. Look at this. They're in the box. Something's going to have to happen. And just taken away. Just swiped away. And just booted out.
Good job defensively again by the Dolphins. Finding a quick outlet. Let's see if they can get numbers forward here in transition.
It will be tough. Let me tell you, it's 1-on-3. And he's, look at this. And if anyone can do it, this lad can do it. He's going to get past his first mark, perhaps. No, not yet. And there you go. There's that little push. He's out of the way. Not out of danger yet. And it is now. He's going to get a yellow. Bit of retaliation for his friend getting.
Yeah, I think a little bit.
Just amazing how that none of these players just like not giving any quarter whatsoever. They want a goal, either a second goal for Dolphins or the tying goal for the Valley. And at this point, a tying goal would get us into more football, and I'm not going to argue about more football.
No, never.
Referee's caught stopping the game. Throw in. Dolphins have the ball. Absolutely trying to get smothered. He's holding it. He's trying to get past three players. Doesn't.
Really looking to take time off the clock there.
And
but
this could be it, Danny. If he can keep this in play. He does. Gets it to his teammate. Valiant has to do a little bit better than that right now. They've tried this many times. And Montero just can't do anything with it. And that is such a shame.
That's really the opportunity when Valley, they can break quick in transition and get out before Dolphins have a chance to set up and really get all their players behind the ball. That's really an opportunity missed for Valley.
And
on
a
that
lot
transition.
Of times they've done that. I mean, Dolphins, we've seen them on their back heel. Valley are on the final third, and they just can't. Something can't. It's not there yet.
No, it's either the final pass or they choose to go backwards and bring other players from the Dolphins back into their defense.
And here come the Dolphins, and they could absolutely put a stamp on this game, but it's not. No, it's not a foul. It's going to go ahead and be a corner. And again, I'll repeat myself. They could put a stamp on this game and just final dying moments of this match make it 2-0.
Dolphins are going to be taking their time. Valley's going to want this to be taken quickly.
And this is where it gets a bit nervy, doesn't it, Danny? Like, oh.
Yep.
What are we going to do? Like, you're almost like this if you make a bad decision, the manager's going to be really mad.
Yeah, this is where you need the experience to take over here and make sure that for the Dolphins, they can run the clock out. And for Valley, if they can get one more bite at the cherry.
Look at this. Certainly. Just very unselfish. Should have taken the shot. Instead, he chose to pass it.
Good look, though. Oh. Man, good look.
Enjoyable 91 minutes. Is that extra time going to be on a razor's edge, or is it going to be a little bit more of the same, but a little, let's say a teeny bit more rough?
I think Valley's really got to throw caution to the wind here and really look to get some more numbers forward. Still have three guys standing on the midfield line.
Yeah. I mean, I'd be throwing everything in the kitchen sink at this point if I was Valley. And, we've seen that done many times, and then the other team comes and counters, but what do you, at this point, do you have to lose? Dying moments.
Moving forward.
Oh, cheeky. Leon just gets it back into the mix. Got to keep it into. Does he run to the corner? Yeah. No, just hold it. Out of touch. Throw in for Dolphins.
Again, Dolphins in no hurry.
So far, so good. If you are a Dolphins fan, if you are a Valley fan, well, you are on the edge of your seat right now. You're hoping the referee adds 10 more minutes at least. Montero with the ball. Needs to get it to his teammate.
He's everywhere on the right, on the left.
And the referee brings the ball back when it was a should have played advantage, but I'm not going to second guess. Here we go.
See if they can launch one last attack here to get in behind.
Certainly something. Oh, well done on
what
both counts.
Save
just keeping the team in the game at this point. Look at that.
Great running behind. Good first touch. Surprised he was able to get it and still get the shot away, but the keeper does a really good job of staying big, getting tall.
Unlucky. Unlucky and almost anticlimactic at this point. And they're just still arguing with the referee. Just not sure what that's going to do right now. The referee's going to look at his watch and just make the time disappear rather than add time. So he doesn't want to get shouted at.
No.
He wants to go home. That last save, Danny, that was
big. Yeah. That was it. And that, I think that was the chance that Valley were really you know, hoping for here towards the end.
Yeah. Hernandez is going to get a steak dinner tonight for that save.
And deservedly so.
Yeah. But again, we still got a few moments. If you were a Valley fan, I wouldn't leave. Just booted. Just trying very hard to cover as much space as possible. So Valley now are on the run. They've got space. There's that boot. Looking for anyone with a black shirt. Montero's open. Goes to his right. There's that cross. And there's... Well done by Hernandez. Could have sworn that was going in. Just too soft of a head.
Yeah, just couldn't generate the kind of power that he needed on it. I think the cross was maybe a little bit too lofted in there to
floating.
Really try to get, you know, a lot of power on it. But
could have just snapped his... Could have done a little snap with his neck, maybe.
Yeah, maybe moving that mass through it a little bit, trying to move his body through it. But...
Well, they're trying again, Danny. Look, they're trying to get up there quickly, as quick as possible. Look.
Valley have moved. They've got a lot of numbers forward now. Really, I think, trying to occupy every player on that back line. But the Dolphins doing really well to absorb the pressure and are smart.
Kick it out. Waste a little bit of time.
Yep.
You know? And, yeah, I've been saying that. Well, I've said it. I'll say it again. They've been near flawless in the back. So... Very well done. Goalkeeper doing more work in the final 10 minutes than... It's not over yet, folks. Valley with the ball. He's going to get past his mark. And he gets a corner. I don't know if that... We haven't seen corners that have been dangerous during this match, but this could be the one.
Up comes the goalkeeper.
Goalkeeper.
This could be
it for
Valley.
Let's make it happen. Let's make it happen. Goalkeeper for the draw. Floated in. Oh.
Rosewell, good timing, but just couldn't direct it down. Tough header.
Very, very, heartbreaking. Really heartbreaking. I'm okay for, you know, extra time if it becomes a draw. I really am. Danny, how about you? Would you be willing to work?
Yeah,
another hour or so.
Absolutely.
Okay.
I feel like there could still be some fireworks left in this one.
It's been such an interesting match. You know, it's been so many different sort of variables, and the referee breaks hearts in the Valley, but the Dolphins are cheering like it's going out of style. Well done. What an amazing match. We've seen everything. So the full-time score here in Irvine, California. Valley 0. CD Delfin de Abasolo 1. The Valley 0. Dolphins 1. I want to thank everyone. Just stick around for a few moments. We are going to cut and return for the trophy. Or are we? No, we are going to... No, stick around. We are going to be watching the trophy.
Stick around. We're going to watch them give out the trophy.
Yeah.
We're going to take a quick break here and then get back with
you
guys.
Yes, yeah. We deserve a break. Yes. We'll see you in a minute. Folks, there you have it. Celebration, joy, jubilation. The Dolphins are going to the semis, and it was a hard battle.
Absolutely.
And they absolutely deserve it. And, you know, it's just wonderful. I wish I was down there celebrating with them, but you can see that they're going to hoist the trophy up any second now. We'll give them a second.
There they go. Really enjoying it. They stuck to their guns. They played the same way the whole game, really with a lot of heart and passion. Good organization. And this is a just reward for a long season and a good performance tonight.
So, Danny, they're going to the semifinals. We know what they did well here. What could they improve going into the semis?
Well, I think that they're going to want to spend a little bit more time in possession.
Yeah.
Try to take care of the ball a little bit more. See if they can create some attacks that aren't in transition mm-hmm. as much. But I thought that their defensive organization was very good. Their commitment was very good. And you know, they're hoisting the trophy tonight for a reason.
And Valley, they have to go back home. Obviously, very long journey. They're going to be back next year. What do you think they should be, after this match, what are they going to be working on?
Well, I think that they need to hold their heads up high, too. They put in a good performance. I think that in the final third, they're going to want to work a little bit more on the coordination of their running and their crossing and a little bit of their finishing. It was really just the last pass letting them down in the final third.
Well, the Dolphins are, in the OC. Hopefully they'll go visit a few theme parks while they're here to celebrate with their family. It's been a fantastic match. I can't wait for the semis and the finals. They're going to be on the East Coast. I want to go ahead and just repeat. It's full-time here in Irvine, California. I want to thank the TVE Max family, obviously the UPSL, Del Real Foods, and I want to repeat the final score, Dolphins 1, Valley 0. My name is Simon Allen. I'm the Dalai Lama of soccer. Next to me, Danny Califf. I want to go ahead and thank everyone on the TVE Max family doing a great job today. And I want to bid everyone an adieu. Have a great rest of the weekend, and we'll see you next time.
All right.
Bye, Danny.
Thank you, Simon.